Hi guys, it's Morgan, and today I'm going to be talking about episode 4 of season 2 of Riverdale, chapter 17, The Town That Dreaded Sundown. Now, if you haven't seen the episode, this video will contain spoilers, so if you don't want to be spoiled, stop watching the video now, go watch the episode, and then come back. Or if you don't care about being spoiled, keep watching. Also, in my reviews for the first 3 episodes of season 2 of Riverdale, I talked about the episode as a whole, but for this review and my future Riverdale reviews, I'm just going to be talking about my thoughts on different moments in the episode and moments that I liked or didn't like. So with that said, here's my review of episode 4 of season 2 of Riverdale, chapter 17, The Town That Dreaded Sundown. When Hermione told Veronica to break up with Archie, I was glad when Veronica said she wouldn't. But I also wasn't surprised. I mean, I don't think Veronica would break up with Archie just because Hermione told her to. I also thought it was funny when Hiram said that he was happy with all the chaos going on. There are times when I don't like Alice, but I felt sorry for her when she confronted Betty about Betty helping Polly run away, and she said that she's always terrified whenever Betty leaves the house by herself, or when Betty doesn't answer the phone when Alice calls her. And I think any good mother would have those feelings. I was really mad at the Serpent Sweet Pea when he told Jughead that the Black Hood is doing their work for them by getting rid of the Northsiders, and said he was a hero. And you could tell that Jughead was upset about that too. I was really annoyed with Archie when it seemed like he didn't care that he was risking suspension in his quest to defeat Black Hood. I understand he wants to protect Fred, but Fred wouldn't like it if Archie got suspended. I felt really bad for Betty when she got the letter from the Black Hood that said he was doing everything for her and that he was inspired by her speech at the Jubilee. Especially because she was really proud of that speech. When Reggie didn't want to get suspended and told Archie that he and the other boys were out of the Red Circle, I didn't blame them. But I did think it was nice when they came back to the Red Circle because Archie didn't tell Principal Weatherby that the Black Hood in his locker was Reggie's. When Hiram told Veronica that he didn't remember what he and Archie talked about, I didn't believe him. There's no way he forgot what they talked about. Even though I suspected it would happen, I didn't like that Tony was coming between Betty and Jughead. When Jughead didn't answer Betty's call because he was talking to Tony, and also when Tony said that Betty thinks the Black Hood is a serpent because Betty doesn't like the serpents. Even though Betty said that wasn't true. When Hermione told Veronica that Veronica's loyalty to Archie is noble, but blind loyalty is stupid and dangerous, I just thought, isn't Hermione's loyalty to Hiram stupid and dangerous? I thought it was sweet when after he found the letter that Black Hood wrote to Betty, and also found out that Betty was worried that Archie would blame her for everything that was happening, Jughead told her that Archie knows who the bad guys are and Betty isn't one of them. When Veronica told Archie that she threw the gun in the river, I thought that was smart. But when it was revealed that she didn't throw it in the river, I was okay with it because she used it to stop the football players and serpents from fighting. When Hiram told Hermione that the town's love and trust of Fred could work in their favor, it made me wonder what they're up to. When Betty and Jughead cracked the Black Hood's code and ran to the town hall meeting to tell them he was coming there, I thought it was stupid that Mayor McCoy told everyone to stay in their seats. So it was good when Betty pulled the fire alarm and everyone left. I thought it was sweet when Archie told Veronica that he doesn't want to think about what could have happened if he had the gun at the fight. And Veronica told him that he's not a killer and kissed him. When the Black Hood called Betty at the end of the episode, with his voice disguised, it just made me want to see the next episode right away to see what he says. At this point, the only suspects that I have that could be Black Hood or could be working with Black Hood are still Hiram, Mary, and Hal. Only it seems unlikely that Mary would be involved. But you never know. Hopefully the next episode gives us more clues. Thanks for watching, guys! If you have any suspects, let me know who they are in the comments. And if you want to see any of my future videos, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!